Welcome to our Edgewonk Trading Journal Review number 8. And we are taking another deep dive into one of our customers' trading journals. Whereas we focused a lot on all the different performance metrics and statistics during our latest reviews, today we are going to focus more on the qualitative side of performance review. Edgewonk combines the best of both worlds. We have all the metrics and performance data a trader needs. Plus, Edgewonk also includes all the journaling and diary features that are so valuable for journaling purposes. So let's take a look at this journal, and thanks again for sending it in. If you want us to review your journal, make sure to check the link in the video description below. So at first glance, we can see that the trader is making money. He has 84 trades with a win rate of 45%, a good positive average P&L, a profit factor of 1.56, and an overall net return of 26%. So how do you go about improving a profitable trading system? And here you typically have two choices. First, we want to look at the losses and we want to understand what went wrong on the losses. Can we avoid some of the losses, which will then help us boost our win rate? And we can then also look at our winning trades. How do we turn our winners into bigger winners? And that will also improve our bottom line. So let's first look at this first drawdown period here, which happened roughly between trade number 35 up until trade number 57, 58 probably. In Edgewonk, you can very nicely analyze this section. So what you can do is just click on one of the data points here in this graph. You will see then the date here. We have the 13th of May this year. And then we want to look at where's the graph again going upwards. We can see we have the 23rd of May in this year. So what we can do is we open the filters and we have this date range filter. And then we just go to May and we want to select this period. So we set roughly 13th until 23rd. And even if we extend this date range a little bit, 11th until 25th, then we still see we are capturing this whole drawdown. And we see that during this period, the trader took 23 trades, a win rate of 34%, a negative average P&L, a very small profit factor, and a loss of minus 9%. Because we said we're going to focus more on the journaling and the qualitative side, let's go to our journal. And what I really liked about this journal is that you will see this trader has pretty much for all of his trades notes. This is indicated by this icon here. We can click on one of those notes, we scroll down, and then we'll see the trader has written very detailed exact notes that are helping us now to understand what he thought at the time, what he did, mistakes that he identified and things that he want to do better in the future. And he said, for example, another trade turned from profit to loss. So this already indicates that there seems to be an issue where profitable trades are turning into losses. Let's try to keep that in mind. And he also said, however, I became overly focused on chasing profits to recover losses. So that's also something that a lot of traders are struggling with. And then as you can see, he started trading with hope, which is never a good sign. When we now go to his advanced trade data, we can see that he entered the trade as a revenge trade. He closed the trade early and he recklessly managed the trade. So obviously that's not great, but it's good that you identify this and that you are really objective about this when you are doing your performance review. Here he clearly was in a losing streak. Let's see what his thinking was at the beginning of the losing streak. He said that he opted to close the trade prematurely because he observed the price movements towards the stop loss and he prioritized capital preservation over further losses. This doesn't necessarily have to be a bad thing. However, this is often referred to as trading your P&L, where you're not making objective trading decisions based on the price charts that you're seeing, but more based on what your P&L is currently saying. This typically happens when traders are doing prop challenges because they have a specific goal that they're shooting for, or when they are in a drawdown and they want their account to get back to break even. That's very common. It's not necessarily a bad thing. However, if you're not doing your analysis objectively, very often you will see that you're missing profits. And what he says in his trade comments is that it was a great entry. He closed it early and he managed it according to the plan. So that's a good sign. And now let's see what happens during the losing streak as the losing streak gets worse and worse. He also wrote in the end, the trade did not yield any profit and it should have prompted me to reconsider my position after the initial stop out. So initial stop out makes it sound like a revenge trade. Let's go to the advanced trade data and you can see it was indeed a revenge trade, The exit comment is stop loss hit, and he managed it according to the plan. So here the entry seems to be a very big issue. Going back to our trade comments, we can take a look at his trade exit. And here, this is my biggest recommendation for the trader. He has three exit comments: closed early, stop loss hit, and take profit. And those are not the ideal comments for your trade comments, because they just describe what happened. So the stop loss was hit, the trader closed the trade early, and the take profit is hit. That's pretty much what can happen on your exit. There's not much more. But the best way to use your trade comments, exit entry and trade management, is trying to understand your trading behavior. What did you do? And try to describe positive or negative actions. And here, just small changes could be enough. You could, for example, have a comment closed early, correct, or you could have one closed early, incorrect, so that you can later understand that closing the trade early was according to the trading plan or it was not. And that will then also help you in your analysis later on. Stop loss hit as well. You could have one comment called stop loss hit okay or correct, and you could say stop loss hit late, which could then indicate that you should have closed your trade before, but you didn't, and you let the price run out, maybe based on hope, maybe just you aren't paying attention. But later you can really understand your trading behavior. And that's the goal when it comes to those trade comments in Edgewonk. Take profit hit is one that you could probably still keep, because that's according to the plan. You have your profit target, and when it was hit, then you followed your trading rules. Here, for example, the trade management comments are really nice, and there's nothing that I would change. You have according to the plan, you have not according to the plan, and you have reckless. Reckless obviously is could be a little bit subjective, but I'm sure that the trader is aware of how he defines the difference between not according to the plan and reckless trading behavior. And while we're here, just take a look at the trade entry comments. Here we also have very good comments that they really describe trading behavior. The great entry, so this was probably 100% according to the rules. Too early, very clear. Revenge trading, also very clear. And impulsive. Impulsive might be also be, there might be an overlap with impulsive and too early, or impulsive and revenge trading. So this, the difference might not be as clear. And you can see he only tagged one trade for impulsive trades. So sometimes when you find yourself that you're not sure about what tag to apply, it could be that the tags are just too similar and there's a big overlap. In that case, you could try to slim it down, eliminate one of the comments, and then your journaling process will be more straightforward. All right, so we looked at this drawdown period. Let's get rid of the filter. And there's another drawdown period that we can identify here. From this top to here, the trader eventually recovered, but this also seems to be a losing streak that we could start to observe and just see what the trader is doing here. So it's starting on the 21st of June, and it's going until here. The performance is ticking up again, 26. So let's try to get this in a filter. We're going to our date range filter once again. We're going to June, and we set 21st until 26. Let's see, we still have some winners in here. So we can fine tune it, 22 until 26, and it looks much better. So that's the period that we are working with. We have only 7 trades, 2 winners, 5 losses, very low win rate. And let's see what the trader is saying here. Again, we can see he has notes on all of those trades. The tilt meter on average looks mostly green, very small green though. Here we have a red one. So let's see what is happening here. And he wrote there was no take profit on this trade because I was close to losing my prop firm. So we can see that what he said in the beginning, that he wanted to recover his losses. And I said that often this is true when it comes to prop trading. This seems to be the case here. And he said, I wanted to see if I can regain some of my losses by trading the correct side of the trend. So he was outside when he placed the position, and you can imagine the level of focus I had when placing it. So it seems that the trade did work out, but it's far from an optimal trade. And you can see impulsive, he closed the trade early, and reckless trading. So he got lucky here on this trade. And although it looks first like a good winning trade, it is a lucky trade. And it probably could have just as easily ended up as a losing trade. And those trades are dangerous when you get rewarded for bad trading behavior. Let's take a look at another trade here. And here we have a takeaway. So that's great. I would always recommend to have a takeaway so that you can just skip ahead if you just want to get the basic message out of it. And he said the key takeaway from today's trade is to move the stop loss to break even once a substantial profit is achieved. And we have seen it a few times now that he seems to be struggling with his trade exits and in general with staying in a winning trade. And that's where our trade management graph, I think, could help this trader a lot. When we go to the chart lab and the trade management, we can see that this data doesn't look quite right, especially here. Whenever you see such a big dip, typically means that there's some issue with your data. So let's hover on this data point, because that's the difference between here and here. So something must have gone wrong. So it was a long trade. The entry was at 1.27019. And typically, yeah, the stop loss is here the cause, because the stop loss is above the entry price, which is not possible on a long trade. And in Edgewonk, it's so important that you always keep your initial stop loss with your trade. Only if you have your initial stop loss with the trade, then metrics like the reward to risk ratio, the R multiple, and also the trade management graph can help you here a lot. Here then later, the graph skips higher significantly. And again, it seems like he moved his stop loss very close to break even. Here the stop loss is at 1.27105. And here you can see the stop loss is just 1 point below. So I'm assuming he moved the stop loss during the trade, and then he also entered this stop loss here in Edgewonk. So my recommendation for the trader would be to pay more attention to his trade management graph, which means that for all of your trades, you need to have a take profit, a stop loss. Those have to be the initial values. And he is also doing it when you go to the journal, you scroll to the right, original take profit hit has been used for most of the trades, not for all. If you don't use it for all the trades, the data will not be as helpful. But when you do this, the trade management graph will be of big help. And for this trader, it would be one of my main recommendations, because it seems like that he is not quite as sure what to do with once he's in the trade. Of course, we have seen when we look at the trade comments that he seems to be having an issue with revenge trading and too early trades, although you can see we have only two. So revenge trading seems to be the major issue. On his exits, we can't really say what is the big issue by looking at the comments, because as I have said a few minutes ago, it doesn't really tell you what the trader did. It just gives you the outcome of the trade. And that's why I think it would be so helpful to also get the trade management graph up and running together with improved trade exit comments. I think that would help the trader significantly. One thing I noticed is that when we go to his diary, he's making good use of the sessions. So he's coming to his trading sessions fairly regularly, and he's entering new trading sessions here on a very consistent basis. Let's take a look at one of the sessions that has 8 trades. He's rating it 3 out of 5. And he's writing here, "This week was a great learning week. I've learned a lot about how I should manage my trades. I've acted upon my edge and received solid entries. However, it was the management that lagged to see the trade close in profit." So as I suspected, this seems to be his issue, the trade management and his exits. But as I just giving him a few tips, I think this could help the trader move forward. "I must have a trade management system in hand." Yep, absolutely. So it seems like by looking at the trading data, we were on the right track by recommending his improved trade exit comments and also the usage of the trade management graph. So this is a very great practice. You can do this once a week at the end of your trading week, or on the weekend you come to your trading session, you create a new one, and you just write down the thoughts of the week, you write down the lessons, things that you want to improve, and that way you can build a great catalog where you can follow your progress over time. So this was a little bit of a different trade review. The goal was to really show you the power of using the journaling and diary features in Edgewonk. And even without looking at all the different performance metrics and statistics in Edgewonk, we could gain a solid understanding of what the trader is doing, where he is struggling, and how we can use that then to craft a plan going forward and what then to do next for this trader.